over our years together, Kate and I have made so many wonderful memories. Some of them we remember very vividly, and some of them we don't, thanks to margaritas. We've seen each other through it all. Kate is the kind of friend you want in your corner. She is loving, thoughtful, genuine, supportive, and she always has your back. I have never once doubted her love for me, and I am so thankful for our friendship. You will always be my sister, and I want nothing but the best for you. I prayed many things when she moved. I prayed that she'd find peace. I'd pray that she would find friends here that would love and support her like we do. And I prayed really hard that she would meet a man that knew her worth just like I do. I just have to tell you, Jeff, you are the man that is meant to be with Kate. Your patience, your kindness, your humor, your genuine honesty is what I prayed for Kate. You truly love our dear Catherine with your whole being. And I know that she loves you the same way. And I am so grateful that you two found each other. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. To Jeff and Kate, may your love be all of those things forever. I love you.
Jeff has been a constant pinnacle within my life. Every single important moment within my life, Jeff has been there. He's also, like some of the best men that you've seen here tonight, he's brought them along with him to help them share within those important moments in my life. So I couldn't ask for a better friend than Jeff. I remember when Jeff met Kate, and he's like, "What do you think of Kate?" And I was like, "Yeah, like she's fantastic. Like she seemed like a really great girl." And but the thing is, I could see a little sparkle in his eye. Like I knew that there was something different about this woman. There is something very special about her. And like, look at her. She's beautiful. Wow. Jeff, you've picked a fantastic woman in Kate to be your lifelong partner. I love you, Kate. I love you, Jeff. So let's give a toast to Jeff and Kate. We love you. Here's to a lifetime of happiness and shared memories. Let's go get it!
These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love for you, that are holding yours on your wedding day, as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years, and with the slightest touch will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will countless times wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow and tears of joy. These are the hands that will help you to hold your family as one. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it. These are the hands that even when wrinkled and aged will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness. With just a touch.
My dearest Kate, my beauty, my love, my inspiration. You're the smartest, most loyal, and dependable woman I have ever met. Today, I am the luckiest man alive because I get to make you my wife. We knew right away that we had found our person. We can continue to discover things about each other But at our core, where it really counts, in our hearts, we are one. There is only love. I promise to stand by you, always. I promise to love and respect you. I promise to be patient, caring, and kind. I promise to be the very best husband to you for the rest of your life. I promise to give you all the love you deserve. I promise I will be there for you forever. I'm not going anywhere. With you, I will create a happy home and a loving family. When you are sad, I will comfort you. When you are sick, I will care for you. And when there is joy, I will share it with you. I wouldn't do it with anybody else. I love you.
Let your presence be welcome, your hearts be glad. For everything there is a season and a time and a purpose for every matter under heaven. And this is the time, and this beautiful place is the place to celebrate the wedding of Kate and Jeff. We have come to do all those things, old and new, appropriate to such an occasion, to say solemn words, to confirm their covenant with each other, to recognize in this event the place of family, friends, and the human community, to praise God and the Holy Spirit of this life, to laugh and to cry, to sing and to feast and to dance, and above all, to rejoice in love and in its endless possibilities. Kate and Jeff, you stand here in this beautiful setting, surrounded by those who have given you life and continue to give you love, friends who have come from near and far to celebrate with you on this memorable day, this day which you will never, ever forget. And we are all so grateful that we've had the privilege and opportunity to be here with you on this most special day in your lives to celebrate with you. My tradition calls the bride and groom two words, which can be translated in two ways. We call you Re'im Ha'ahuvim, which can either mean friendly lovers or loving friends. And throughout your life, may you always be, as you are today, friendly lovers and loving friends.
My father gave me some of the most wonderful advice when I got married. While we were doing our father-daughter dance, he just whispered in my ear and he said, "Be careful of the words." Wow, really wise. Because you know, it's true. You don't ever really remember what you argue about, but you will always remember what you say. So, I guess what I learned from that is that I'm supposed to offer you some sort of advice from my years of experience being married. So I'm going to try to do that. You gotta give a little, take a little. You gotta laugh a little and cry a little until the clouds roll by just a little. That's the story of, that's the glory of love. Make someone happy.
Jeffrey Connor in the room. Oh, it's you guys. That's a mouthful. So it's official. You are now married humans. Sir Jeffrey, you are a bold adventurer. You have flown down in your magic bird machine and swept my beloved daughter off her feet and into your arms to have and to hold. And I'm very happy about that. It was about time. She is a precious gem, which I know that you know. Your rock of ages. Her love for you is so great, so true, so permanent and lasting. It was not given lightly. Believe in it. It's for you only. Take care of your wife. Miss May, my only daughter, what can I say? You have made such great karma for yourself. At the age of 4, you stood on the pool deck at Katona, completely bare-assed, hands on your hips, and you said to the world, "Why doesn't everybody do as I say?" You set off with sheer bravery to the Wild West of Seattle to seek your fortune, change your life, and change the world. And all along the way, you had outwitted and outwitted all the frogs and the trolls and the dragons and the clowns that came calling. And then karma stepped in and showed you your prince. And lo and behold, he was a real man, a true man. Trust in him, my darling Kate. He will not fail. Do what you can with what you have, with where you are. St. Paul, the man, not the city in Minnesota, wrote a famous letter to some confused Corinthians. That's Greeks. They were in need of some truth. And he wrote this beautiful letter, which you should read once a year. And it's poetic, and it's many words, and it boils down to just 3 words, and they are love never fails.
Mr. and Mrs. Jeffrey Connor, ladies and gentlemen.
On Saturday, April 5th, 2014, you entered my world and it was changed forever. Like the song said, the moment I saw you, I knew that I adored you. Your sense of humor, calm nature, and incredible ability to be the best at everything you do. These are the things that helped me fall in love with you. But it's how you love me that made me want to be your wife. The loyalty of your love is like anything I have ever known. You teach me how to love me better. You care for me and you care about what I care about, even when you don't understand it. Even though sometimes it feels like we couldn't be more different, there's one very important thing that brings us together: the desire for a life experienced by each other's side. Jeffrey Daniel Connor, I will love you forever, no matter what the odds. I will love you because loving you is the only choice that makes any sense to me. Because I know you will love me unconditionally and without cause. Because you too recognize the luck that was granted to us when we were pulled together that rainy Saturday in April. There's always been a string tugging my heart to Seattle. I know now it was you on the other end. I'm so happy it's you, Jeff. I can't wait to be your wife.
Build your world around her. Make someone happy. Make just one someone happy. And you will be happy too.